Hello fellow founders, this is Anatoly from CXDojo and this is our technology corner. Today we are going to talk about the specifics of choosing technology for a new or existing project. And using this information you will be able to perform research yourself, justify your business partner decisions, and most importantly understand when someone is trying to bullshit you by recommending some technology that is not based on your needs. Continue watching and I'll explain you what I mean and surely throw some examples. You may ask me, are there more than one chip technology available or don't they all look alike and I just randomly pick one? Well, it turns out yes and no. So you see, almost every problem can have multiple solutions these days with similar budget and time. And from what you choose depends which features you will be able to add later and how much money it will be taken from your company as you go. Let me give you an example. Let's say you are starting Magento eShop and your team is asking you which theme to choose. There is a newer thing called progressive web application that is capable of reaching 100% on Google score and that is created to provide you with smartphone-like experience on the web. On the other hand, there is a standard Luma theme that with proper amount of maintenance may supply you with a decent performance as well. Using this information, I would probably pick the first option because it sounds way cooler. But if we dig a little deeper, the choice becomes not that obvious. You see, all the bells and whistles that PWA has come to the price. And it means that its structure is more complicated. That makes it only experienced engineers to work with. And in the long run, it will suck your budget faster than the Luma. At the same time, the standard Luma theme has a wider adoption rate and more information on the internet. With all this information, Luma doesn't look like a bad option either. But we are here to solve your problem, not to make a new one. But before we jump into the hardcore stuff, let's figure out the theory. The main criteria for choosing any technology is money. How much budget does it take to develop a new features or run a system? And in the long run, it hugely depends on three things: architecture, development process, and entropy. Or in other words, how quick your system becomes something that is called legacy code. And keep in mind that first two items are meant to neutralize the effect of the third one. But let's get back to our technologies. What do we mean when we say technology? So, in scope of this video, we use term technology to describe any framework that is used for building your system. It may be global framework like Ruby on Rails or Django, or something significantly smaller like tiny JavaScript framework that is used for converting date and time for different time zones. So, if we take typical software unit and see how it's written, we'll see that it looks like a sandwich of technologies. So, at the bottom of the sandwich is the platform, the thing that is converted to ones and zeros. Then it comes a core layer that specifies how we get the data from the database, how we get data from API or in file system, how we process some basic operations like multiplication and stuff like that. Then it comes the business logic, the thing that most of developers are focused on. Then is the layer that is responsible for presenting data to the happy user, and it's called UI. You see, all these layers contains dozens of technologies that someone at some point have chosen for you. But don't worry, you don't have to take all of these decisions yourself. We will help you. Before choosing a technology, you must collect your functional and non-functional requirements and sort them onto three categories: must, need, and want. Where first is the feature that you cannot go without, second is important features, and third, features that are nice to have. Then it goes shortlisting process, where you filter out technologies that are not suitable. The good candidate for shortlisting should implement features from first two categories, must and need. If you're lucky, you're gonna get one technology that you will go with. But most likely you're gonna get two or three. And what do we do in this case? Let's move on to find out. To pick the best option among available, let's turn to an ancient developer wisdom, which is don't try to create what's already created. What I mean by that, people spend thousands of hours thinking how to solve problems similar to yours, and turning to their experience seems like a good idea. What I'm trying to say is that there are already established technology combos that work well on a project similar to yours. If this is a new project, try having a look at technology stacks like Ruby on Rails or Mern, or even PHP has some good options. If you are an existing code base, remember, try not to change it unless it's Visual Basic or Fortran or something that your grandma used for programming spaceships. So, if we get to this point, let's talk about money. And doing so is not very easy because first, I recommend you to do the math for 2 or 3 years, and second, it includes several aspects. First is the cost of the development, which mostly includes engineering expenses. And second, the cost of support, that also includes expenses for licenses and for hardware. Well, to check expenses for hardware and licenses is pretty easy. Just go to your provider's website and check pricing with them. But how much a developer resource might cost? One of the options to check that is to go to a resource like Fiverr or Upwork and check a developer's rate. Just open your browser, enter a website, then in search bar, enter a search query. For example, Flutter, and browse the developer's rates. But unfortunately, many technologies will have similar pricing models, so we'll have to continue our research. Another important value for every technology is the size of the community. The bigger it is, the better, because it shows that more people use the technology. The easiest way to check it is go and visit sites GitHub or Stack Overflow. They will help you to understand the size of the community for each technology. And there are several ways to do that. To check GitHub, open the website, go to a search box, enter your search query, let's use Flutter for this purpose, and pay your attention to things like amount of repositories or amount of users. To check Stack Overflow, go to a website, pick tags from the main menu and enter your search query. Here you can see the amount of watchers and the amount of questions. Also, using LinkedIn, you can check how many developers with a specific technology are available in your area or in some other location. Another thing worth mentioning is the frequency of the updates. Frequently used technology regularly gets updated with hot fixes and patches. And it's worth mentioning that it hugely depends on the size of the community. The bigger it is, the more updates technology gets. But keep in mind that if technology gets updated way too often, it's most likely in its active development stage, and you'd rather either wait or pick something less volatile. On the other hand, you don't want to pick something that hasn't been updated for 6-7 months or more. And the last but not least is worth checking software version. So if we take regular software development cycle, it starts somewhere from version 0.1 and goes all the way to infinity. But very important point in this process is probably version 1.0, when original ideas are getting implemented. And the more further away from version 1.0 software version is, the more market adoption it has. But it doesn't mean that products with software version less than one cannot be used. They can, with precaution that the design or the API of this framework may change in future, and you'll have to adapt it to a newer version. So, how to check software version? Go to an official website, try to download installation file, and its name will contain the software version. Easy as pie, isn't it? So, to sum up, choosing a technology can be exciting and tricky, but we're here to help you. Feel free to contact us with your questions and ideas.